Okay, good afternoon. My name is Michiel Roos, and I want to talk about Dapper 3 Code Scanner. I've been working with Dapper 3 since a while now, and I like to make tools that make your life and my life, of course, a bit more fun and a bit easier. I've been working for Michiel Roos since 2018 as the boss, and yeah, it's nice, it's been good. You may know me from very long ago, NC Static File Cache. I think we discussed it yesterday with some guys. It seems to be like 15 years ago already. Dapper 3 Homestead was a development box on Vagrant before there was DDEV, and the Dapper 3 Try, which was like a Vagrant box in which you could try the latest Dapper 3 versions out of the box. These are the services I offer: migrations, all kinds of Dapper 3 work, code despaghettiing, whatever you like. Yeah, Dapper 3 migrations, we all need to do them from time to time. If you're lucky, you have to upgrade from 8 to 9 or from 9 to 10. If you're not so lucky, you may have to upgrade a big client from 6, maybe from 4 to 8 or something. Upgrades come in all shapes and sizes, and of course, yeah, the sizes, small sites, big sites, sites with many extensions. Current version that's officially supported, long-term support, version 9. But 6.2 is also officially supported through the extended support package, which is nice for big corporations who move slowly or slower than other corporations or companies. Any people running version 4? No hands? Yeah? Version 6? Yes, a bit more hands up. Version 7? Yeah, some clients, 7, yeah. So there's all kinds of versions in the wild. And the question is, should you migrate the installation or build it up from scratch again? And yeah, there's not really an answer to the question, because yeah, it depends. Third-party extensions, which are in the repository, then you may be in luck, like if you use the news extension or the PowerMail extension, you can more or less migrate up to a higher version. PowerMail, you will need to rename the tables or copy data over from one table to another table name because it changed the table names in between some versions. For the news extension, there's a quite smooth migration path, and for other extensions, yeah, your mileage may vary. Custom extensions, which some other guys or some other agencies built for your client, or which you built for your client, it depends if you can easily upgrade them. Depends on the size, how many lines of code is there, do you understand the code, does it have nice code to read, can you, yeah, is there documentation, are there tests available so you know if you've upgraded, if you broke something or not. So yeah, and if you decide to migrate and not to write it again from scratch, how do you go about it? Do you improvise? Like, what this is in Dutch, but you'll understand, I think. So you upgrade the core first, and then yeah, lots of stuff breaks. You fix the code that breaks stuff, and you check if it works. If it works, then you're done. If it doesn't work, you go back to fix stuff that breaks or that's broken, and then if it works, you're done. So that looks like a nice, simple approach. Another approach is to first look at all the extensions and fix all the code up front of all the extensions, then upgrade the Dapper 3 core. and then see if it works. So maybe then you have a higher chance of stuff working out of the box right away. And if it doesn't work, then fix the code and reiterate until you have a running site again. This one looks more complex than the first graph. But in fact, version one looks like this. You upgrade the core, you fix the stuff, and then if it works, you win. And then you go to production and say, oh, wait, we forgot some stuff. And then you have to go back and fix the code. And so it's actually, well, you get bitten by it in the end. So it's better to take the approach to first inspect the code. And well, the bigger your site is and the bigger the project, like an old Type 3 installation, this is just an example. 6.2, about 117 plus extensions, some of that are in the Type 3 TER and some that are not, some and many that are not. No housekeeping since the migration from 4.2 to 6.2, which means they installed some compatibility layer extension that was available on 6 to keep code running that ran on version 4. And now they want to migrate the site up to, well, they couldn't go to 8 at once, so we first had to go to 7. So that's a lot of, yeah, a lot of code to go over and fix. But luckily, we have change logs in Type 3. Since version 4, since version 7, the guys, the core developers, decided to log every change they made in a restructured text file and say, like, we made this change. It's a breaking change. Stuff will break. And look for this code, and you can replace it by this code or not, or we just removed it, and you should do something else. And also, the deprecations are in there with the description, the impact, and the affected installations, and possibly a migration path. You can find them online. And they're grouped by version of Type 3. So you can look one up. And it explains like what you need to do if you encounter this code in your extension. And this is nice. It helps. Hang on, how do we get back? So that's good. There's also a code scanner since Type 3 version 9. I don't know who knows it already. It's in the install tool. And you can click a thing which says, like, you've got deprecated code in your extensions, fix it. And this only goes about this is only about versions or code deprecated since version 9, so stuff that broke from version 8 to 9. And it's cool. It helps. So it basically scans your extension, and it finds stuff that's broken, and it lists the deprecations. And well, you can effectively go in and know where to find the stuff you need to fix and fix it. But this is from version 9 and up. Like, there's no such stuff for the older versions of Type 3. And the way this works is it uses the REST files. And there's no stuff. No soup for version 6 and 7 and 8. So it's you're on your own for the lower versions. So the technique that's used in the version 9 extension scanner in install tool, it's a Type 3 scan library thing, which was extracted from the core. And it basically consists of the Nijic PHP parser, which builds an abstract syntax tree from your PHP files. So it goes through all the PHP files in your extension and puts them in this structure. And then there's patterns which are extracted from the REST file documentations. Like, it looks for a certain class name and function name together. And the PHP parser can say, like, this is positively a match for that breaking change. And then it says the line and which file you need to change. So that works in the backend, but it was extracted to a library, and I built upon that to make a standalone module, a standalone a command line tool, which will also scan for deprecations for version 7, 8, and 9. And it can output plain text, HTML, JUnit, Markdown, whatever you like as a report format. And you can write your own report formats if you understand Twig, templating engine. Here's a demo, but I can show you a live demo. So the thing I did was I went over all the REST documentation files from version 7 to up to version 9, the ones that did not have patterns, and I wrote matching patterns for them, just as they were made already for version 9. So this took about, I think, 2 days of work to get all the patterns in, and now that we can also scan for deprecations for version 7. I'll do a demo. Is this readable? Oh. Yeah. Like this? Bigger? Okay. Yeah, it's just a PHP file, a var file, PHP archive file, standalone, so you can run it everywhere PHP is available. And you can run it standalone, which means you can just have the folders with the extensions and the Typo3 scan tool, and you just can generate reports. You don't need a running Typo3 installation or anything. It's just a bare command line based thing. There are three commands, like help, list, and scan. Well, list just lists the commands. So that's not very. So we can look at the scan command, and it expects a path argument, which you put at the end here. So we can try, like, I've got the devlog extension here, and it's going through all the PHP files in there and scanning for deprecations. And it scans against a target version of Typo3. So it finds all the stuff. And I think the default target is version 9 in this case. So if you want another target, you have to specify the minus T option on the command line. So you say minus T 7, then it will look at all the deprecations for version 7. You see there it has strong and weak matches, which is not correctly spaced here. Strong matches means that it's fairly confident that the code it found actually matches a deprecation or a breaking change. And a weak match means that it maybe matches. So that's not a. Actually, the weak matches should be made less, because sometimes a weak match means I only match the function name, the function call name, and I don't look at the class. So this gives some false positives. And then the breaking changes and the deprecations are here, like 3% deprecations and 96% breaking changes. And then it lists the file it found the change in, the line number, and then the link to the deprecation and the title of the deprecation. So.
Question.
Yeah?
Yes. Just strong matches then in the end.
A lot of matchers have the class also in there, but there are also matchers that don't have the class in there.
Because you figured out that's not possible or complicated?
I don't remember. So I can say like now I'm scanning for version 7. And I forget the syntax. The T7, and then we want, say, we want the format, the output format, to be HTML. Then it'll spit. Wait. And then we want the output to specify the output file, report file. It would be nice if it would write to a default file or something. But whatever. Report.html. So now it'll scan for deprecation version 7. And then you get this, which is basically the same output. And then it also shows you the preceding lines and the lines after the change. So you can clearly see where you need to change your stuff. And otherwise the output's the same. Like, so now you know exactly what lines of code you need to change to fix it before upgrading. But this only works for PHP code, and this would be nice to also have this work for, oh, maybe have an autofixer, but you can tell something about that maybe later. You could do the same, of course, for TypeScript and for fluid templates, because they also have breaking changes and deprecations, and this Type3 scan tool currently only handles PHP. Was made possible by one of my biggest clients because I needed this to upgrade their site. So thanks to them. Any questions up to now? Zero questions. Okay. Yeah, the autofixer is interesting.
I'm going to talk about that in a few minutes, so if you're interested, you can come. But I have the same problems, TypeScript is not covered through templates.
Yeah.
It's not covered, so does anyone have a solution for that? Is a TypeScript parser or linter or something like that?
I think it's linter.
Is the internet? Yeah. Thank you for your attention. So since we have some time left, does anybody want to see something like DDEV, but then only for Linux, native on Linux? No? Good.